Are you sure that being a beloved former wrestler turned A-list actor has absolutely nothing to do with it?
Man, I think it's just a coincidence.
Okay, but... Dr. Pat, we are here today for the hard truth. What actually causes male pattern baldness besides being the world's greatest action star?
You know, being an action star really has nothing to do with hair loss, man.
Well, that does make sense. Because Dwayne, national treasure, the Johnson, was rocking a smooth crown before ever becoming the highest paid actor in Hollywood. Am I allowed to say that? So what does cause hair loss?
It's a combination of two main factors. One is the production of androgenic hormones, one in particular, DHT, which is dihydrotestosterone. And the second is your genetic sensitivity to that DHT hormone.
So you're born with it, like the...
Oh, actually, no, don't say that.
Or like YouTube hosts with effortless charisma.
Well done.
What's the point of DHT if it makes you go bald?
During pregnancy, childhood, and puberty, DHT is an important male hormone that leads to secondary male characteristics, physical features like your body hair, your genitalia, the shape of your jaw, and your voice are all a result of DHT.
So you're saying that being blessed with a perfectly symmetrical jawline will not make me go bald?
Nice.
The hormone affects your jaw shape. And it could affect your hair, particularly if you have hair follicles that are particularly sensitive to the DHT.
So how exactly does this normally rad hormone mess with my man bun?
What it does, DHT attaches to receptors called androgen receptors. Once it's attached, it actually goes to the hair follicle and it miniaturizes them. Effectively, it reduces the ability to make normal hair. In the first part of the process, your hair starts thinning and eventually those hair follicles will not be functioning.
Okay, so if it's a genetic sensitivity, then why do some men go bald in certain areas and not others?
Because all of your hair follicles are not equally sensitive to DHT. Some areas of hair follicles, particularly on the rim of your scalp, have a low sensitivity to DHT. So even those men who are balding will still keep a semblance of hair.
Okay, but hair loss can happen to anyone, so what should people be aware of?
There's many, many other contributors to hair loss, but to highlight a few is anxiety and stress. There's actually a condition called telogen effluvium, where after a period of really intense stress, you can have generalized loss of hair. The second is nutrition. If you don't eat a diet that's balanced in protein, you can actually lose hair. Even iron deficiency can cause hair loss. And finally, a period of really extreme weight loss will also lead to loss of hair. And that's why it's important when you get treated for hair loss, you have a really customized formulation around what works for you, depending on the type of hair loss you had and in what phase of hair loss you're in.
If only there was a platform out there that offered prescription strength solutions for hair loss.
And off the HIMS platform, we are very focused on the personalization of care to get the right medication with, you know, the guidance of the provider, the prescriber, for each individual patient.
Right, because we can't all be my favorite wrestler, who then became my favorite actor, who then became an international icon. Thanks for watching another episode of Uncomfortable Questions. For more content like this, click like and subscribe.